Good morning from Lynn from WisconsinGarden.net. It's November 20th. Usually by this time we've had a little bit of snow, and for sure we've had ice. Look, I still have snapdragons that are blossoming, and some that are still blooming, getting ready to pop open. While at the same time, we've got ice on the pond, because it was in the 30s, the low 30s last night. But if you look over there, you'll see that there are some oriental poppies that have seeded themselves since summer and are now blossoming. Tiny little oriental poppies. It's amazing. It's a truly strange fall, but we're enjoying it.
And where are we heading?
Right now we're headed to a new indoor farmer's market. Now that the outdoor farmer's market season is done, because it's too cold to be outside for hours at a time, the city of Milwaukee, or the county, is trying a new indoor farmer's market, and we're going to go check it out. Let's go. Here we are at the warm indoor farmers market. Just take a look at what is here.
Yep, I should have it on December 1st. I'm sure it is, but I know that they're making us some
from Rolling Meadows Sorghum Mill out of Elkhart Lake, Wisconsin, and we make sorghum, and this is our plant of sorghum. It's about 10, 12 feet tall, and it doesn't have a cob like corn does, and we make the sorghum, and we harvest from September to October in Wisconsin here, and sorghum is high in antioxidants. It's 1,700 per tablespoon about, and our glycemic load is 4, which is very low. We also, when we harvest the sorghum, we take the stalks and we squeeze it out, and then we cook it down like you do maple syrup, to give you a 100% sorghum syrup. So it's sort of like sugar cane in a way. I mean, you're relating it. They're two different plants.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Yeah. I would understand.
They're two different plants. Similar in the way it's processed.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Now when you use, I see you have sorghum flour. When you use sorghum flour, do you have, can you use that like regular flour, or do you have to mix?
We have a recipe flyer that we usually give people to help them get started.
Yes.
It doesn't have the gluten in it, so you have, it's like gluten-free. The flyer is, here's the flyer.
Oh, wonderful.
And now where are you located out of?
We're located out of Elkhart Lake, but now the sorghum flour, we get that out of Kansas. That's not a Wisconsin product, because it takes a longer season to grow the sorghum seed head, which comes from a white seed.
Okay.
And that's a sweet seed. If we tried using our sorghum seed, but it's a red seed, and there's tannins in red seed, and that there's a bitter in the tannin. And so we get it out of Kansas. And that's a gluten-free facility, celiac certified.
Good.
So excellent.
Well, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
never knew we were going to have this education today. This is fantastic. You learn something every time you come to a farmer's market.
And what are you going to do when you start baking?
I'm going to be using some sorghum.
There
for
you
sure.
Go.
Oh, and it's also high in calcium, potassium, and iron.
There you go. Thank you, Brenda.
Thank you, Brenda.
Thank you.
How you to keep it?
It's a heim roll, and our cheese company is Saxon Homestead Creamery. We're a 160-year-old farm along Lake Michigan. We've got 1,200 acres of grazed for our grazing systems. We've got 200 paddocks that four different breeds of cows are grazing. Our goat cheese is on the end. We've got a couple national awards for that cheese. This one just took a first place at the American Cheese Society August 28th in Seattle. And our cheddar, our two-year bandage wrapped, was a second place winner in Seattle. We're very proud of the cheeses. There were a lot of big dogs in the event from Mexico, America, and Canada.
That's so, very good. I just had some.
So these are all raw milk cheeses, and when you get grazing in there, you get flavor. Very unique. This is the terroir of Lake Michigan. And in the revolution of fresh food, people want to know what is in their own backyard, like you people are into. Yeah, we appreciate homegrown. It's the nostalgia of what we remember grandma and grandpa to do and present. We've gotten so far away from that. And the blandest speaks for itself. When you taste fresh, you're always going to want to come back here to this event. You taste fresh and flavored. This is homegrown. Yeah.
Delicious.
Yeah, thank you very much.
So you've got the one goat,
goat
variety, and the rest of the different
cattle. We've got four different breeds in our herd. My husband calls them the pizza herd, but that is specifically for components and flavorings in our milk.
So different.
So we've got Normandy from France, the Brown Swiss, the Jersey, and the Holstein.
I'm Holly with Becky's Blissful Bakery. We have, today we're sampling the beer pretzel caramel.
And they're wonderful.
They're amazing. They're made with Lakefront's organic beer. It's a new flavor as of this month. Becky's candy shop is located in downtown Pewaukee, but she sells her products in many other local stores. You can find her in the Brookfield and Sendix, the Sendix and Brookfield, Delfield Fine Food, Outpost, and we have lots of different flavors and an amazing product. And
all,
they're all organic.
And they're delicious.
Give us a little tour of all the products.
Okay, so I've sold out of the dark chocolate sea salt today, but we have the original with sea salt. We have the turtle, so you'll have dark chocolate and pecans in this flavor. This is just the original, and this is the amazing sample of today, Lakefront beer pretzel. And then you have the dark chocolates, and then we are out of the dark chocolate. And the caramel sauce, which is amazing. People like to just eat that right out of the jar.
Yes, I can imagine.
And then this is Becky. Hi, Becky.
We had a really good time here at the farmers market. We'll be back. We've met a lot of nice people, good stories, and wonderful products. We'll be eating our way through the next week.
Wait,